About the Super Bowl that happened this year. So what happened in 2013? I didn't watch it, but I heard a lot about it from Facebook. So we're going to read an article because some crazy things happened this year. And we're going to find out what those are. All right. Welcome back to class, Savant.
Oh, thank you.
It's nice to see you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right. Hey, Wolf Wolfie. How are you?
Fine. Fine. And you?
Pretty good. All right. So everyone knows that today we're talking about American football and not soccer, right? Just to clarify. All right.
So we are going to talk today about the soccer?
About American football, the Super Bowl, the 49ers versus the Baltimore Ravens. Okay. So we're going to check out this link, and I've posted it in Verbling chat and also in our group chat. Right? Because this year, there are a few events within the United States that happened, one being the Sandy Hook Elementary shootings, and the other during the Super Bowl, there was a blackout. And a blackout is when we lose power, and it's very rare for us in the United States. Usually, it only happens during storms or, you know, in old houses if someone uses their hairdryer, television, plugged in their phone at the same time, uses their microwave. So we're going to check out this article. Is anyone able to not access it? So is anyone having trouble getting to the article? No?
No.
Okay. Cool. All right. Let me just zoom in. Okay, so would anyone like to start reading for us at all?
Yeah, I can start.
Yeah? Okay, great.
Okay. Super Bowl 2013's big moments. Ray Lewis, the ill-fated 49ers comeback beyond the blackout, dominated the week's storylines. But the character of such a massive event can also be distilled by sifting through more intimate details. One final flip through my Super Bowl notebook. Another satisfied customer.
Mm-hmm.
Neil Patrick Harris, star of popular sitcom How I Met Your Mother, walked the red carpet at high-profile parties, played in DirecTV celebrity flag football game, and appeared on the New Orleans shot episode of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Keep?
Yep, you can continue.
Okay. But mm-hmm. He also shared private moments from his first ever New Orleans visit with his 5 million Twitter followers. He tweeted pictures of the shrimp and grits he savored at restaurant Revolution, the Sazerac he sipped at the Carousel Bar, and Mississippi River Sunrise. It wasn't clear if he was up real early or real late. He puzzled over a blurry image of Walter Wolfman, Washington, and the Roadmasters at DBA, snapped during an equally blurry night. He'd probably be willing to file a famous friend of the city brief in support of New Orleans' bid for the 2018 Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so can anyone tell me the big moments of the Super Bowl this year? So what are the four big moments of the Super Bowl? They're mentioned in the beginning.
Ray Lewis. The big moments are Ray Lewis which one is the ill-fated at 49th comeback. Mm-hmm. Beyonce.
Yes, this Beyonce?
Beyonce, yeah, Beyonce.
Okay. What does the 49ers comeback mean? So,
they won?
Sorry?
They won the Super Bowl?
They didn't win the Super Bowl, but it means they the 49ers comeback means that they were doing really, really crappy beforehand, maybe in the beginning of the game, maybe during their season. And comeback means, you know, they're able to improve, and they were able to make it to the Super Bowl by chance, you know? So
recovery themselves, something like
that? Yeah, come back. Let's get some synonyms. Recover themselves, improve. And you'll hear this a lot in sports terminology. Oh, okay, I'll post the link again. And don't worry, I'll be using screen share. So come back, recover themselves, improve. Okay. Any other synonyms? Just letting you know, Gokhan, I'm the professor, so if you want to meet me, that's very rude.
You did.
Who muted the teacher?
Right. So this does happen where I get kicked out of class sometimes. All right. So sorry about that, Gokhan, but if you want to mute me, that's a little rude and disruptive for everyone else in class. All right. Sorry about that, guys. All right. And what was the blackout again? Can anyone describe that?
The losing the power, electricity.
Yeah. Okay. And then does anyone know why they mentioned Neil Patrick Harris coming to New Orleans? At all?
He's a star of popular star.
Yeah. So he's a popular star.
Yeah.
And he's tweeting about his trip to New Orleans, and this is written from a newspaper in New Orleans. And so they want to have the Super Bowl in 2018. That's why they mentioned Neil Patrick Harris. It's like, you know, come to our town. We're the best. We should have the Super Bowl in 2018 because it's decided, you know, up until that time frame. So that's the next open slot. It's kind of like the Olympics, where all the cities fight to have, you know, the Olympics in their country. All right. Did anyone watch the Super Bowl this year at all?
No.
I didn't watch.
Even I have no idea who's playing that.
Okay.
I think it's not popular. International events is a Super Bowl. Well, is a popular just in United States. But if you look at the other sports events, such as NBA, but I think NBA being more than watch the Super Bowl. I mean, Super Bowl not draw attention like in other sports.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sure. Is there a big difference between rugby and Super Bowl?
Rugby is a little bit different. And rugby is not that popular in the U.S. To watch. It's popular for people to play in school, during college or high school. But there are some differences in the game. Oh. I would describe rugby as like a mesh, so a combination between like football and soccer. So American football and then European football. So it has some characteristics of both, I guess we could say. Personally, I've never seen a rugby game, but I've seen a lot of football games. So is rugby popular in your countries? I know soccer is, but what about rugby?
In my country, rugby, no. It's not. No. Only soccer is famous, you know, in my country.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I would say, actually, I looked up the top watched sports in America, and it goes football and baseball are about tied, and then basketball for us.
Do women in America usually watch this rugby and Super Bowl matches? Because in Turkey, women usually don't like watching soccer or this type of matches.
A lot of women in the United States love sports and love watching sports. I'm not one of them. I like to go to, the stadiums, and I like to see the games there. But if we're just sitting in a bar or if we're sitting at home watching television, I don't want to watch a football match, you know? I want to watch, like, Grey's Anatomy or a movie or something.
I don't know if women and girls really into sometimes in a football in the United States. They all want to be cheerleader.
What does the British call it for the American football? How do they call that? British?
The British call it, so most Europeans call it American football. I guess that's how we should refer to it. That's British English. Americans refer to it as soccer.
Soccer, yeah. Okay.
I confused that. Americans refer to it just as football, and then we refer to football as soccer. Sorry about
soccer,
that.
Yeah.
So American football is football, and football is soccer.
Because when we are talking, I think we are confused, you know, because someone think about the, you know, European footballers, someone think about the American footballers, so...
Yeah, I'm retyping this. So American football is football for me in America. And then football is soccer, which is like the white ball.
Every country used to football, not soccer. Just only United States uses soccer. But except you're saying the British English. Besides in the England, the other countries used to football, not soccer.
That's true.
Can I ask something?
Yeah, go ahead.
Why is it called Super Bowl? A bowl is like, I don't know. Why is it called Super Bowl?
Magic bowl. Magic bowl.
No, not bowl. It's a bowl.
Yeah, it's bowl.
Bowl. Okay, sorry.
Bowl.
Something you eat out of. You know, so you have a plate and then you have a bowl.
Okay.
Maybe the prize they gave at the end of the season, maybe looks like a bowl.
It's a football. It's like that. The prize that you get a trophy, and it's a football. So it's that like lemon shaped object on top of like a stick. Mm-hmm. I'm googling the history because I don't know why we call it that. We just.
Don't go so far, please.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Tough questions.
They don't even... Oh, they're just saying it started with Super Ball.
Okay.
So it did start with B-A-L.
Ah.
But I guess because of maybe accents, Wikipedia is saying during the meeting it was being referred to as Super Bowl, just the pronunciation. So it was supposed to be Super Bowl, it looks like. But
okay.
That sounds so funny to me. Yeah.
And I have another question. Is there a women's Super Bowl team?
Mm-mm.
No.
No.
Why not?
Women usually don't enjoy playing football. It's the women will play rugby, but football, the men take a lot of injuries. So it's a little bit more violent. It's one of our most violent sports besides hockey. And there's a lot more injuries related to football than other sports. So I can understand why women wouldn't. Also in football, if you see a lot of the players, sorry, I work on a different system. They're big men, so they're usually like over 200 pounds. And women just can't get to that size, you know, very husky and very muscular. So that may also be another cause of that. Some of the men on those teams, like the linebackers, so they're what we call like defense, I guess, just to refer to, and they can weigh up to like 300 pounds and they're pure muscle. Like, women just can't do that, unfortunately. So, all right. So I'm interested to see what happened with the blackout. Would anyone like to read this part for us at all?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
From what? Blackout mystery?
The blackout mystery solved.
Blackout mystery solved. The Craig Ferguson show retabbed its both Super Bowl episode area in the week.
But hours before airtime.
But hours before airtime, the host improvised a new opening bit in which he triggered the infamous blackout by recharging Lucy Lloyd's cell phone in a Superdome electrical outlet. An example of a big time TV guy and his team sinking on their feet.
Okay. All right. So does anyone know who Craig Ferguson and Lucy Liu are at all?
Craig Ferguson is a comedian, I think. I saw a few videos on YouTube.
Yeah. So he has a kind of like an evening show, like Saturday Night Live or Jay Leno, where he has people come on and they do skits. And what about Lucy Liu? Does anyone know who she is? She's one of our recent Charlie's Angels. She's Asian American. And she's kind of a comedian. So she does usually comedic movies, but she doesn't do like stand-up comedy usually. And so does anyone understand what Craig Ferguson does to make fun of what happened during the Super Bowl? So he had a show taped. So the Super Bowl was Sunday of this week. And so he taped his show on Wednesday. But then on Sunday, the whole dome, the Superdome, lost power. So, you know, we're televising the Super Bowl for Americans, and then all of a sudden, all the screens go black, and there's nothing, all right? And so what he does to imitate this, because we don't have a reason for why this happened, they don't know why it happened, so Craig Ferguson makes fun of it, and it's the idea that you take your cell phone and you plug it into the wall. And because he did this, he stole all of the power and crashed the Superdome. It's just to make fun of that. Is that clear at all?
I couldn't understand what he did with his cell phone.
So the idea for a power loss usually comes from too many objects plugged into the wall.
Mm, yeah.
So he's like, one more cell phone, and he's blaming Lucy Liu. So
oh.
He's, yeah. She'll do sketches with them. Okay.
So it was a joke. It didn't yeah. happen. Okay.
So we don't have a reason for why. We just lost power. It could have been just because there were too many lights or something. All right. So we're going to take a look at...
Wait, can I ask you, but sorry, yeah. Laura, what does it mean, thinking on their feet? Is that an...
Mm-hmm. Deciding quickly.
Sorry?
Deciding quickly.
Ah, okay, okay.
Choosing
okay.
quickly.
Mm-hmm.
So they thought quickly.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. All right. So we're going to take a look now at this part. All right. Fish, specifically a dolphin, out of water. So we were up here before, so we're going to scroll down just a little bit. Okay. Would anyone like to read this section? We're going to read all of this just to see what happened. All right. You don't have to read all of it. We'll break it up. Don't worry.
I would like to read.
Okay, cool.
Pardon. Okay. Fish, specifically dolphin out of water. The credentialed photographers staking out turf on the sideline during the Super Bowl included Ricky Williams, the former Saints, Dolphins and Ravens running back. Armed with a long lens camera, Williams stood out as the most tattooed and best conditioned member of the press corps.
Core. Okay. And continue.
Okay. The V-est of VIPs. Most everyone of Rolling Stone's February 1st party at the Bud Light Hotel, a.k.a. the Windham, was an important person of one kind or another. But security momentarily stopped regular VIP traffic behind the concert tents, so rapper Pitbull, the party's headliner, could strut to his dressing room trailer unmolested.
And the next one as well. Strut, walk okay. with attitude.
Sorry?
Strut is to walk with attitude.
Okay, strut, okay. So do you want me to continue or not?
Yes, please.
Okay, it was the yes, NFL's please. Town. How omnipotent is the NFL during Super Bowl week? Even cops stationed near the convention center and the NFL concert series at the Sugar Mill wore legal-issued laminates as if they're NOPD or Louisiana State Police official uniforms. Guns and badges weren't sufficient authorization.
Okay. All right, so we're going to take a look at its title. Fish, specifically a dolphin out of water. So, because understanding news articles, it's important to understand the titles as well. Does anyone see a problem with this title? All right. Fish, specifically a dolphin out of water. Is a for dolphin me, a fish? Hmm?
Yes, it's kind of fish.
Okay.
It lives in the water, yeah, but I wouldn't call it a fish, no.
Yeah, so fish are cold-blooded, all right, so, but a dolphin is the mammal, so like us, you know, they're a mammal. And so does anyone know why they refer to fish, specifically a dolphin? So why are they using the word dolphin? Did anyone catch why?
Can you repeat the question?
What team? Yep. So why do they use the word dolphin? What is team uses dolphin as a symbol? Football team.
Dolphins and Ravens.
Yeah.
Because they are clever. Because they are wise, clever, no?
So they're talking about a photographer, so the paparazzi. During the Super Bowl at this one hotel, and his name is Ricky Williams, and he is a former running back. So he is a former football player, and he played for the New Orleans Saints, which are Dolphins. And then he used to play for the Baltimore Ravens. So that's why they refer to the animals. You'll see that a lot in sports articles. They may not refer to the team, but the team mascot or the team logo. So when you hear the full names of these teams, it should be the San Francisco 49ers. And then we have the Baltimore Ravens. And those two teams played in the Super Bowl this year. But you'll hear them referred to as the 49ers versus the Ravens. And that's what's happening here. They're referring to this photographer as a dolphin and a raven because of the teams that he played for. All right, and they're saying that, you know, he was pretty tattooed and best conditioned, so he didn't look like a photographer. For us, they're usually, you know, very skinny, wearing black, maybe smoking a cigarette, you know, the artsy image that we have for a stereotype. All right, and so we're going to work with this title text. So the viest of VIPs. What does VIP stand for? Does anyone know?
Very important persons.
Who doesn't know?
Hey, I don't know. We're just going to go over some slang. All right. So what does the viest mean? The viest of VIPs.
The veriest.
Yeah. So they're saying the veriest.
The most.
Yeah. The veriest.
Yeah. My computer won't even let me type it. It keeps auto-correcting it. Stop it. best, very most important, you know. Yeah, there we go. All right. And so who was the viest of VIPs? The rapper. Viest of VIPs.
Teacher.
The rapper Pitbull. Sorry.
Yeah.
Can you translate me this answer, because I'm a little bit confused, if you can. It is in the topic. It's in the photo there. It's writing this sentence. God shed his grace on thee. Can you see the topic picture in the Super Bowl? There is a line writing above the singer.
Oh, yeah.
This pattern.
Mm-hmm. So it's for us, it's a religious saying. Mm-hmm. So God shed his grace, so his kindness.
Merciful.
Yeah, on us.
Oh. Okay.
We mean us, right? Mean us, right?
Yeah. Us, it can be me, it can be them. Usually it means also you. So God shed, God shed his grace on thee, referring to you. But in this sense, it's us. So you are us. And it is in a song that we sing in church.
But this form of pronouns is from British? The
it's old English, and I'm pretty sure we say this in church, but we also say it, I'm pretty sure, in our song, which we sing before all Super Bowl games.
Do you use daily in American English? Do you use this?
No. You'll see this with Shakespeare, okay. Or okay. Mostly writers writing between. Yeah. Writing before the 18th century.
Okay,
writers, or before the 19th century, sorry.
Thank you, Maria.
Okay. Yeah. Tolkien wrote in the 1970s, but sometimes he uses it as well. Okay. And it is, so we say it in church, but it's also one of our national anthems, America the Beautiful. And that was written...
But what does it mean, shed?
To give, to to scatter,
to spread.
The idea that God is up here and He's dropping His grace
spread.
On us.
Spread.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sorry that I interrupt. You know, because I thought that I'm going to forget this. And
it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. And I guess if we take a look, we should take a look at this. I had a class about this event. It says, the title, After Singing America the Beautiful with Jennifer Hudson during the Super Bowl 2013 pregame ceremonies, students from Sandy Hook Elementary School changed into street clothes to watch the game anonymously from the plaza level seats. All right. So does anyone remember what happened with Sandy Hook Elementary School? I think I had one or two students. I think Wolf Wolfie was there, but I'm not sure. Sorry. there was a massacre this year in the Sandy Hook Elementary School. So as an honor, it's one of the biggest honors in America to sing the national anthem before a sports game. So they invited the students, and that's why you see children at the top of the page. In khaki pants and a white polo, because they helped Jennifer Hudson sing the national anthem. And we also sing it, it's our national anthem. It was written during the Revolutionary War, right as the Americans defeated the British. So if that makes any sense. So it's like a very powerful song for us, and we sing it before every game. So you'll hear it before hockey, baseball, basketball, football. So, good question. Thank you. All right. Okay. So, unfortunately, I guess we'll go back to a happier topic, which is Pitbull, instead of the Sandy Hook Elementary School. And so, why was Pitbull considered the V-est of VIPs? so, does anyone see, like, right
because
here?
Other VIPs were stopped? I don't know why.
Close, yeah. So... they mention in this paragraph here that, you know, the state police, the people protecting the celebrities of the Super Bowl, so the football players and the musicians that perform, that their police badges were not enough, so they had extra security. But when Pitbull was around, he kind of had one of those rock star moments where it was like, fuck this, I'm Pitbull, I'm not getting stopped by security, so he could walk back and forth between his trailer, so where he was staying, and the party where he was performing without being interrupted. So he kind of had a what we call like a fabulous moment, where he said he was the most important. all right. And so does anyone know what is a tradition for the Super Bowl at all? What we have happen?
No.
No? Okay. So it's pretty common to have one big celebrity come. And so this year it was Beyonce. Last year it was Madonna. It was the worst show I've ever seen. last show was Madonna. And what they do is they put on a concert during halftime. So they sing one or two songs, and they have like a huge show. And so one of the halftime shows you may remember is Britney Spears and the Jackson. What's her name? Michael Jackson's sister. I'm blanking on her first name.
Janet Jackson.
And I'm pretty sure they kissed, and then Janet Jackson ended up flashing the entire population of America that was watching the Super Bowl. And that was one of the more catastrophic Super Bowl halftime shows. So since then, we've cleaned it up a bit. So it's usually just a concert, but it's very extreme. So there's a few artists, there's crazy costumes, there's fireworks, there's confetti, there's great dance routines. So it's an over-the-top concert. And that's tradition. And so it's become popular nowadays to bring in artists to have parties in the city that we're holding them. So that's why Pitbull's there, you know, because he did a performance and he's performing through the Super Bowl festivities.
Right. At the beginning of the season, they bring celebrities or in the half time of every match?
It's usually during halftime. And it's just for the Super Bowl. So for other games that are televised, we may have a guest appearance once in a while. You may see a celebrity in the crowd and they'll point that out. But there are no performances usually. The performances are just for the Super Bowl. Any other questions?
So Super Bowl is the last match of the season?
Yes. And whoever wins the Super Bowl are the champions of the year. So last year it was the New York Giants, and this year it's the Baltimore Ravens. So they're considered the best in the league at this point. And so this starts, the season officially starts in October, late September, playing for the Super Bowl. And we have a We have these games that are called fantasy football. Do you have anything like that for soccer at all? It's an online game. So you create teams with your friends, and you pick players and teams that you think are going to do the best, and you try to decide how the whole season is going to turn out. Do you have anything like this for sports in your country?
You mean like gambling? You put money, then you say this team will win and this team.
Yeah. So you can gamble with money for fantasy football, or you can just do it for fun and not gamble any money. So my boyfriend does it, but he doesn't bet money.
Yeah, we have the same thing. You try to anticipate the score of the match. Let's say the team A will win with 2-2. And if it's correct, you get money. If it's not correct, then you don't get.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So we know in Turkey they have it. All right. Great. And so what happens is you end up with a board that has four different parts, which is the leagues. So you have like the Northeast, Southeast, you know, Midwest, and then West Coast. So like the leagues there. And you have all the teams listed, and then whoever wins in each league, they can move forward until you end up in the center with the top teams from each league.
Yeah.
Okay, so the 49ers are obviously from California, they're from San Francisco, and the Ravens are from Baltimore. So opposite coasts played in the Super Bowl this year.
What is your team?
My team?
Yeah.
So I have to say the New York Giants because my boyfriend will get very upset, but I actually don't like football. So... we'll go with the New York Giants. Is anyone a fan of any football teams in America?
Yeah.
Yes?
The Cheeseheads, maybe. I don't know.
The Cheeseheads, who are they?
They are, let me think, Green Bay Packers.
Okay, yes. Okay, so you like the Green Bay Packers?
I don't know. I don't watch Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I just heard of them. Mm-hmm. Or I heard of those crazy costumes they wear, like a piece of cheese on their head.
Yeah. And so, do you know why they wear cheese on their head?
I'm not sure if they produce a lot of cheese in that city, or I don't know.
Yeah, so Wisconsin, I mean America, we're not really known for our cheese. I would leave that, you know, to France maybe. You know, okay. They've got the whole cheese making industry down. Maybe Italy with mozzarella and Parmesan. But yeah, so Wisconsin is our cheese area just because there's a lot of cows. So there's a lot of dairy farms out in Wisconsin. Okay. Dairy farms in Wisconsin. So that's why they're I guess they have a cheese head for their heritage. All right. What about anyone else? Have you heard of another football team in America at all? No?
No.
Yes?
I like the Seattle Seahawks.
The Seattle Seahawks. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. I wish I knew more about football. I just know where that team comes from. All right. So we're going to take a look at just this last part for the last part of class. And I'll go to screen share. So we're going to talk about, you know, the homage to, I'll write that down, the homage to Sandy Hook Elementary School, because we talked about Beyonce, and tomorrow, if you come to my morning class, we're going to talk about, you know, the halftime show and the best commercials of the Super Bowl, because it's tradition for us to have the best commercials during the Super Bowl, so that's why some people watch the game as well, just to see what happens in between the game.
You are not really into football, but I think you're obsessed with the Super Bowl.
Me?
Yeah, sounds.
No, actually, I just Googled all of this stuff right before class, and I had my boyfriend explain football to me, because I don't know anything about it.
But your sounds, you're really into the Super Bowl.
Well, that's good. That means I'm a good teacher. I'm faking enthusiasm, you know? I think it's interesting, but you know, it's not my favorite topic, I guess I would say.
That's why I said you are not into football, but you are continuing to carry on your class about Super Bowl tomorrow morning class.
Yeah, well, the commercials, I think that'll be a good exercise for everyone to share culture as well, because Americans have a different sense of humor than the rest of the world. Yeah, especially from my French students.
So it needs to be explained.
Yeah, but they're funny and they should be pretty animated. And sometimes they're just stupid. So we'll get to see a few of them and talk about them.
Do you have a favorite team, Laura? Yeah. Can I just ask me? If you have a favorite team in Super Bowl?
Well, to please my boyfriend, I will say the New York Giants.
So, New York Giants.
New York Giants. Yeah. They're red, white, and blue. So they have a giant G. That's all I know. All right. So would anyone be willing to read this part at all?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Sandy Hook slips in and out of the spotlight. Perhaps no group experienced the dichotomy of public and private Super Bowl moments more vividly than the 26th, 3rd and 4th graders of Sandy Hook Elementary. The NFL invited the school student chorus, survivors of December's horrific school shooting in Newtown,
Connecticut. It's abbreviated. Connecticut.
Connecticut?
Yeah, I'll write it in. Okay. It's my home state.
Okay. Connecticut, mm-hmm. to sign, to sing. Mm-hmm. America the Beautiful with Jennifer Hudson, herself no stranger to deadly violence, as part of the pre-Jame ceremonies. This was not the first time Super Bowl entertainment has addressed a violent national tragedy. The last time the game was played in the Superdome in 2002 was months after the terrorist attacks of September 11th, 2001. During U2's halftime show, victims' names scrolled across the stage. 11 years later, the Sandy Hook kids stood bravely under blazing lights in the center of the Superdome. Their America the Beautiful was quite a powerful and emotional moment shared by 70,000 people in the dome and tens of millions more watching at home. Mm-hmm. Minutes later, the kids and their parents filed past a group of journalists waiting for an elevator in the bowels of the stadium. Some of us high-fived the kids as they passed. Most of them smiled, no doubt, relieved that their high-pressure star turn was over. Security guards would soon escort the Sandy Hook contingent to sit in section 143. But first, while still out of sight on a ramp leading up to the plaza level, they shed the matching white polo shirts worn during their performance. They changed the street clothes, including the smattering of Ravens and 49ers jerseys. Changing shirts signaled what was likely a welcome transition from symbols of a national tragedy to anonymous gaggle of kids and parents more than ready for the distraction of a football game that is much more.
Okay. So what are they trying to tell us about the Super Bowl when they finish this article? What's their message? No? Anyone have an idea at all? Yeah?
Sorry?
So what is the message? What is the message that they are telling us at the end of this article?
The trail of the tragedy of Nitum, no?
Yeah.
They sing in before and to remember the people the violence.
Yeah. So
I don't know more.
No. You listed it great. So the children are singing in remembrance of their lost peers. U2, the band from. Very popular in the 90s,
yeah.
In the early 2000s. Oh crap! What's the word in English I'm looking for? but dedicated. Sorry, dedicated their show to the lost lives of the 2001 terrorist attacks.
Yeah.
So for us, the Super Bowl. They're trying to say the Super Bowl is not just a game. Super Bowl is not just a game. And also, it's one of the only ways, you've seen America, it's huge. It's one of the only ways we can reach all of our public at the same time, because the Super Bowl is the most watched event/television show in the country.
Yeah.
So it's a great way to reach our public. All right. Okay, and so I wanted to ask you, in your countries, so a soccer match, so an American football match, or baseball, yeah, or cricket. I know cricket is pretty popular. Do you have more than just a sporting event? So when you go to these, is it much more than that? Or is it just, you know, food and friends and the game? You know? Well, so for us, yeah?
I think it's about match and the rival. They are rivaling. We have, for example, we have two teams, soccer teams here. Mm-hmm. They are very big rivals. So in their match, it's all about rivaling. It comes more than a match. Sometimes it comes very feisty.
Feisty, yeah.
Like,
oh, feisty, rivaling. Aggressive or festive?
Yeah. Sometimes aggressive. People are getting angry at each other. It's very feisty, like opponents, rivaling, competition, yes.
Okay.
Competition.
Interesting.
Are you talking about football hooligans or what?
You can talk about anything, because any sport, because I know American football is, you know, very specific to my country, and that you have other sports that are more popular.
In our country or in your country?
In my country.
I'm from in Spain, and in my country it's very popular the final of Champions League. I don't know what can I do, what can I say about the.
So what do you do for the Champion League? Do you have a party? Do you go to the bar? Do you go to the game? Do you go to the stadium?
No, I usually watch because each year is in different city of Europe.
Okay.
Champion League.
Okay. Well, anyone else? So, Maria, you mentioned hooligans. Do you have a lot of hooligans in Sweden?
Well, it happens that fans from different countries sometimes fight during the game. Yeah, okay. We had some problems with that. And since I don't watch football, soccer very much, I don't follow these kind of clashes, but yeah, we do have some problems. I think it would be good to have some, like, other event in the halftime, some kind of halftime show like you have, because that would kind of, I don't know, make it more of a party than a fight.
Yeah.
You see what I mean?
Yeah. Soccer hooligans are pretty aggressive and pretty passionate about their sport and their team. So I understand. We don't refer to them as hooligans here. We call them diehard fans. So like they would die for their team, like they just love them so much. That.
But do they fight during the game, like, or in halftime?
Usually not.
Okay.
Only in rare cases. You know, it tends to happen when, you know, there's alcohol and, you know, the sports are a little aggressive. But usually, for us, the Super Bowl is a time to be with your friends. And watch the game, eat sandwiches, chips, wings. Chicken wings are really common to eat, and drink beer and soda. So it's like there's a very typical menu. Places will start selling Super Bowl sandwiches like a few days in advance. Mm-hmm. You can like order them a few months in advance. Oh, and pizza, Domino's and Papa John's pizza. So they'll send out coupons. Get your Super Bowl pizza today. Order it in advance and make sure you have it for your big party. Stuff like that. So I have a class in 2 minutes, so I'm going to let you guys go. But I hope you see there. I'll see you there. We're going to get a lot of practice speaking, so it'll be a good class. Right?
Okay.
Have a good day, guys.
Okay. Bye.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Laura.